The word of God is alive and powerful, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of the soul and the spirit and the joints and the marrow. And it is a critic of thoughts and intents of the heart. All scripture is God-breathed and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God might be mature, thoroughly furnished unto all good works. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth, or accurately handling the word of truth. Dear brethren, Apostle Paul told in Philippians 3:13 and following, I have been not yet attained, and I am going for attaining, so pressing forward for the mark that has been kept, and I have to attain that spiritual resurrection in Christ. Therefore, dear brethren, the ultimate goal of each and every believer is to attain that spiritual resurrection. To attain that spiritual resurrection, many hurdles will come. Therefore, we need to know how to unsheath the word of the Lord, transfer from the pages to our soul, and be acceptable in the sight of Lord, that we are capable of doing a great business unto Jehovah. That great business which has been given for us through the mind of Christ, through Bible doctrine, through the great polytheism of privileges of all time. And how can we be worthy to Christ is what our concern is all about. But the problem is, today, rejection of Bible doctrine is greater, and acceptance of false doctrine is even greater in the pulpits. The men do not know how to rightly divide the word of the Lord, who come to the congregation, who come to the ministry, because it requires the true isagogical, categorical, and exegetical explanation of the word from the original languages of the scriptures. Until and unless they do not go from the original languages of the scriptures, they are not really interpreting the mind of Christ by the divine author, who is none other but our Lord God, the Holy Spirit. And the word of the Lord is alive and powerful. It will divide asunder between the soul and the spirit. It is a critic of thoughts and intents of the heart. It will also divide between the bones and between the joints and the marrow. And that is what you and I have to learn. You and I have to concern. You and I have to be worried about. The greater our failure to look and to understand about this great leadership which has been taking place in the pulpits. If it is an apostate one, you cannot grow up to the reality, because many will be easily led to fix their attention upon the secondary things and to neglect wholly upon the one primary thing. And Satan has blinded their eyes toward that which is of eternal value, because biblical truth is the sole complete revelation of God's perfect plan for the believer. Those who neglect his word have simply rented a room for the devil, and the devil never makes them to learn the truth, but rather it causes them to be involving in those things which they think that the achievement of the goal of the pastors could be easily bought by counseling, by personal visiting, or social programs, speculative prophecy, emotional-based worship services, and what little theology comes from these pulpits is absolutely primarily false. Attaining or maintaining salvation through works and rituals, spirituality through the use of the now-defunct spiritual gifts, like healing, man's liberation, through social engineering, various other philosophies that confuse and detract from the person, work, and significance of Christ. Since this is devil's world, dear brethren, false doctrine is very popular. As Paul warned, it spreads like cancer. They are deluded believers in every generation, drawn to the teaching for such kind of an apostate pastor, because every time this pastor stands up to speak, the souls of his followers move deeper into confusion and further from biblical truth. Even Apostle Paul warned to be aware of those pastors who teach to you varied things, not from the original language of the scriptures, and you, which way you need to go, you need to decide. You are waiting for the real truth of the word of the Lord to be thoroughly examined and thoroughly taught. Are you still wasting your time, not able to understand that you have been permanently indwelled by the ministry of Lord God, the Holy Spirit, to train you up when you are using Reborn properly in the privacy of your priesthood, to train you up to the principle of the word of the Lord, and cause you to become a perfect, mature believer in the great polytheism of privileges of all time given to us in this unique dispensation of the church? We are being termed out as Alekhine Ketesis. The reason that we have been termed out as Alekhine Ketesis is that now we belong to the church, the called out ones, the assembly ones, and this church where we have been called out. We need to show forth the true glory of Lord and the true glory of Jehovah. The greater our failure to understand the simple truth, the greater will be the failure for us not to know the reality of Bible doctrine. In simple words, it is for us to be aware of our life, to be aware of the enemy, to be aware of the principle why Lord has kept us alive, rather than looking upon and living a life that is vain glory. We need to go for maximum glorification for Christ, and that's not possible if we are not taking the daily intake of Bible doctrine. Therefore, dear brethren, we shall continue tomorrow. Today the wind is again too strong, and we are little bit having disturbance in recording the scriptures. But at the same time, dear brethren, As we come down tomorrow, we shall start up with the Polytima privileges again, with our head bowed and eyes closed, the closing movements being dedicated to those who are here without Christ, without hope, and without eternal life. Inaudibility and intellect, God the Father, that you believe upon Christ, that is the moment itself, you shall have this eternal truth. This eternal truth for is for very simple, believing Christ, you shall be saved. For the believer, the great merit is to grow up in grace and the knowledge of Bible doctrine, so that searching the scriptures diligently, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. And whereas for the pastor teacher, the great mandate is very clear, to carry soton lagan, herald the word in season, out of season, because of the diamatrum of witnesses wherewith you have been called. The great diamatrum of witnesses is nothing but indwelling Trinity, followed by Bible in our hands. And if there are no witnesses, do not worry, besides nature, the entire angelic host will be our witnesses, and the first one will be, let get the Holy Spirit. You need to do the words and the preaching when you have been faithfully prepared to tell the reality of the truth. Not because that we have greater wisdom we come and proclaim, but it is because we have a burden laid on upon our shoulders, that why the people are being destroyed. Our Lord said in Hosea 4:6, my people are destroyed because of the lack of knowledge. The same thing now it is happening even in the churches. Though we have the completed canon of scripture, people are getting destroyed because of their negligence, because of their indifference, and because of their failure to expose to the face-to-face teaching, or whichever manner it might be, to the intake of proper ice concept with the dispensing technique of dispensations in rightly dividing the word of truth. Therefore, dear brethren, you think and you decide which way you want to go, and that will be ultimately for the truth. Father, we are grateful for the privilege that thou hast given to our fellowship through thy word. Help us never to worry about the softies, but rather be worried about your word with the burden to be filled, to pertinently take thy word through exegesis, a nice concept or dispensing technique of dispensations in rightly dividing the word of truth. For we ask it in Christ's name, Sovereign Lord. Amen.